A few weeks ago at WWDC, Apple unveiled its new spatial computer called the Vision Pro, a mixed reality headset. But will it be accessible? And how? We don't have all the answers, but we do have some. This is Carrie on Accessibility, where we talk about technology and accessibility. So let's talk about the Vision Pro. First, let's go over the design and some specs of the device. The headset looks kind of like a large ski goggles and has a wide gray adjustable strap that wraps around the back of your head. The front is glass and it appears black and it acts like a screen, and we'll get back to that later. The frame around it is a metallic color. It has 5 sensors, 6 microphones, and 12 cameras, some pointing outward to the world in front of you, some angled to the side and down to your hands, and some pointing towards a user's face. It has a button for taking photos and videos, and it has a knob that Apple calls a digital crown, but it looks larger than the one on the Apple Watch. You can use the wired external battery that lasts for up to 2 hours, or plug it in for what Apple calls all day use. Inside the headset, it uses 2 high-resolution micro LED displays for each eye that shows the world around you based on what the camera sees, and then places apps on top so it looks like they're floating in front of you. For those who wear glasses, you can purchase Zeiss custom lenses that magnetically attach into the device. It also has 2 speakers, one on each side, with spatial audio. It runs on the M2 chip and the new R1, which handles processing for all the sensors to make it low latency. This allows users to control VisionOS, which is the operating system on the headset, with their eyes and hands. During the presentation, they really emphasized eye tracking. It will also have optic ID, something similar to Face ID, but it scans your iris. At launch, most iOS and iPad apps will be available in the Vision Pro App Store. It will be available next year and will retail for $3,499. Woo! The front screen, the one I mentioned earlier, will show people around you if you're looking at apps. It shows this kind of shifting lights visual. I guess people won't be able to hide that they're not paying attention, but I don't know. They also showcased a feature where on the outside screen, people can see a reproduction of your eyes and the part of your face that's hidden behind the headset. It's like a visual pass-through so people can see you and you don't have to take the device off. But they're not really seeing you. It's just a digital copy of you. The cameras inside the headset are streaming your face onto the outside screen. And get this, Apple calls this feature iSight. Yep, iSight. So when a blind person uses this, can they say that they have iSight? But what concerns me is the accessibility. Will we be able to use this with VoiceOver? How can somebody who has dystagmus, like me, control the operating system with my eyes if I can't control the movements of my eyes? What about people with prosthetics? How does a blind person know where to look and focus? How can we know the context? I also have aniridia and don't have an iris. Will I not be able to use Optic ID? And what will I be able to use? How much can I zoom into apps? And can I make them closer? Because in the presentation, they showed these AR app screens all the way across the room. I just have so many questions. Apple shared a presentation directed to developers, not users, on creating accessible experiences on the Vision Pro. I'll link that in the description if you want to go see it yourself. Here's what I learned from the video. They showed a list of accessibility features that would be on the device. So it will have dynamic type, voiceover, zoom, spoken content features, reduced transparency, switch control, reduced motion, on-off labels, assistive touch, full keyboard access, voice control, bold text, pointer control, sound recognition, guided access, dwell control, type to Siri, sound actions, button shapes, color filters, increased contrast, and hearing aid compatibility. So pretty much most, if not all, the accessibility features available on iPhone. You can assign VoiceOver to the accessibility shortcut, which is a triple press of the digital crown on the Vision Pro. You can move to the next item by pinching your right index finger. This pinch gesture confused me at first, but basically you just touch your thumb to your index finger, and they refer to this as a pinch. To move to the previous item, you pinch with your right middle finger. To activate an item, you can either pinch your right ring finger or your left index finger. When you're using VoiceOver, you'll have a set of VoiceOver gestures, then there'll also be a new direct gesture mode. When this is enabled with a left index finger triple pinch and hold, VoiceOver won't process its standard gestures, but will let users interact with the app's hand gestures directly. As for Zoom, it will act like a lens and you'll be able to pan around by moving your head. There really wasn't much information on Zoom during the presentation, which is disappointing. Dwell control allows users to tap, scroll, long press, and drag without their hands. Pointer control lets users choose other inputs besides using your eyes. You can choose head, wrist, or index finger. I would love to know if I can combine Zoom with pointer control and use my wrist or index finger to control Zoom. I've tried head movement based headsets before, and after a while, it honestly just makes me really dizzy. For those who use switch control, there will be new menu options for adjusting the camera position. Guided access will support those with cognitive disabilities by restricting people to a single app and minimizing distractions. They do this by backgrounding other apps, removing ornamental UI elements, and suppressing hardware buttons. That's all I was really able to glean from the video. It had a lot of information about how to code and develop for the Vision Pro, but unfortunately, didn't really share what the experience will be like for AT users. I can't wait to get my hands on this so that I can try it out and see what it's really like and how VoiceOver, Zoom, dynamic type, and voice control. I think it's really exciting. Apple seems to have a knack for making new devices and making innovations mainstream, and I can also imagine that they did put in a lot of time and effort and hopefully testing by real users for the Vision Pro's accessibility, I hope. As I mentioned in the latest ANAT news video podcast, link below if you haven't watched it yet, visual search was a feature somebody found on the Vision Pro. With visual search, people can use the Vision Pro headset to get information about an item, detect and interact with text in the world around them, copy and paste printed text from the real world into apps, and translate text in 17 different languages and more. I'm really hopeful that this will enhance accessibility. Just imagine it. Imagine using the new point and speak feature, hands-free, where you can just point at things. Like, you'll be wearing the headset and you can point at things in your environment and it'll be able to speak aloud to you whatever you're pointing at. Imagine being able to use Seeing AI and Be My Eyes and Be My Eyes Virtual Volunteer, especially when it's able to process video and describe things live, and just imagine being able to use other accessibility apps hands-free. Directions and pointing a phone camera can just be really challenging for somebody who's blind, but it could be so much easier if you're using a headset. I think the Vision Pro has incredible potential, especially combined with all the advancements in AI, but I still have so many questions. As with all new products, privacy is a huge concern for some people, but to be honest, I'm in the camp that they have all my information anyway, so I'm personally not so worried. But it's definitely a legitimate concern. What worries me more is the isolation of the product. Sure, they can show your face on the 3D screen on the outside, but that doesn't substitute that social connection, and that's kind of really weird and honestly creepy for me. Sure, I and people who are more introverted than I am would probably really enjoy and appreciate that, but we are social creatures and still do need human interaction. We do, right? Yeah, we do. We're already obsessed. Yes, I said obsessed with technology. I'm fully aware that I'm very guilty of this, but if this becomes mainstream and eventually replaces smartphones and people start walking around with these, I don't know. I'm not sure I want to live in that world. Ah, who am I kidding? I'm totally here for it. There's some pros, there's some cons, there's some fears and excitement, and I feel like it's all bundled together. The technology is already here and coming, so let's just enjoy it. Eventually, hopefully, they'll make it smaller, lighter, less intrusive looking, and a lot cheaper, and have real wireless charging, and the digital world and reality will be blended seamlessly, and the whole world will be more accessible. Here's hoping, right? And I think the Vision Pro can be a step in that direction. I would love to try these in person, and hey, if anyone knows how I could do that, let me know. Those are my thoughts on the Vision Pro. Let me know down in the comments, what do you think about this product? What are you concerned about? What do you think the accessibility is going to be like? Are you going to try this product? I would love to hear from you. Thank you so much for watching, and I will catch you in the next video.